V7 Plus presents the News Hour at 9, driven by Hyundai, co-powered by Cisco, light years ahead, and Sera reflects my style.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's Friday night, it's 9 p.m., and you're with me, Navika Kumar, on the News Hour this evening. And ladies and gentlemen, Rahul Gandhi called it a Gabbar Singh tax. Mamata Banerjee changed the picture on her Twitter to black and protested against demonetization. The opposition has been indulging in a lot of drama to create a picture of an economy in a complete free fall. But now, three successive reports in less than 3 weeks have completely deflated their attack. The latest in a report by the credit rating agency, that is the Moody's, that report coming out today, the investor service which upgraded India after a long span of 13 years, after 2004, ladies and gentlemen, and that's the endorsement of the goods and services tax that has been introduced, as well as the demonetization. That's the Moody's report that upgraded India from BAA3 to BAA2. That report coming in this morning. Also, the Pew survey that came in just yesterday, the Pew Research Center, which showed that Modi government's approval ratings were at an all-time high. India's Prime Minister remains the most popular political figure with approval ratings of 88%, and the Congress Yuvraj lags behind considerably. And then there was the World Bank Ease of Doing Business report, in which India climbed an unprecedented 30 spots and broke into the top 100 club. The World Bank credit rating assessment sustained these business reforms for achieving an unmatched improvement. With their criticisms on slowdown, but not one but three international objective agencies saying that what is their excuse now to criticize Prime Minister Narendra Modi and his Modinomics? That's the question we'll be asking on Modi Backs Modi tonight on the hashtag that we are putting out tonight. But before we go across to that big debate, let's take a look at the top headlines that are making news this Friday evening.
Through the reforms that are being implemented and some of them still planned, the economic strength and shock absorbency of India will be improved.
Massive boost for Modinomics. Moody's upgrades India's sovereign rating after 13 long years. Center calls it GST and demonetization impact.
These ratings, I mean, those had been measured 6-7 months back when there was no adverse impact of GST.
I think it's a clear case of grapes being sour. It's a very clear case of despondency.
Despite Moody's upgrading India from positive to stable, it's not good enough for the opposition parties. Government calls it a case of sour grapes.
And then he groped me and attacked me. And then I tried to fight back, but then he fled.
You know, they reached 10 minutes later. I mean, if they would have reached just in time, we would have nabbed him there and then.
Shocking capital horror caught on camera. Journalist molested in Delhi metro station just minutes after a lawyer was groped by the same pervert.
I would say it was unfortunate, but the CISF team is already there. It was already there, and they had just patrolled the particular spot just before the incident occurred.
Cops call molestation shocker an unfortunate anomaly, but Times Now exposes security farce. Most metro stations in the capital don't have 24/7 security.
मैं दीपिका पादुकोण का नाम लेना भी पसंद नहीं करता कहां रानी पद्मावती और कहां ये पैसे पैसे पे नाचने वाली
Fringe crosses all limits. Rajput Sena hurls unpardonable slur at Padmavati actress. Deepika Padukone is demeaning women protecting Rajput honor.
You're watching the News Hour at 9.
It's a massive vindication for Modinomics. Moody's, an international credit rating agency, has upgraded India's rankings after a gap of 13 long years. While the government has called it global endorsement of the mega reforms rolled out by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, like GST and demonetization, but the opposition is still unconvinced, claiming that a foreign agency can't understand the situation on the ground. Take a look at this report.
In a major endorsement of Prime Minister Narendra Modi's economic policies, US-based rating agency Moody's has upgraded India from positive to stable, reaffirming that the India story is alive and kicking.
Ratings has improved from positive to stable. Now, this is an upgrade which has really happened after 13 years. And we welcome this upgrade.
The upgrade by Moody's is based on expectations of more reforms enhancing India's growth potential. Top economists working with the government say the upgrade was overdue.
I would say that this is recognition of the reforms India has undertaken. It is something that should have happened before. It is a belated recognition on the part of Moody's.
We felt that the rating agencies had not recognized India's underlying macroeconomic situation. So that's welcome. It's also, I think, a recognition of the actions that the government has undertaken, GST, bankruptcy, MPC, and all of that.
India Inc. too has given the thumbs up to the Moody's upgrade, saying going forward, better days await the Indian economy.
It is a reaffirmation about that how the world or the international investors view India.
This is a clear good signal that the world is noticing India's move towards stability, and I think India should continue down this path. I think the opportunity ahead is even more.
The recent commitment to recapitalize the banks and the formalization of the insolvency and bankruptcy code, I think, will really go a long way in strengthening the banks.
But even as the government has welcomed the endorsement of its work, politics has broken out over the Moody's upgrade.
Basically, a recognition of the changing face of India, of good governance, of investment, but most important, a governance of integrity and honesty.
But I have one word of caution. We, in the government at least, should not become euphoric about praise by an external global agency.
Well, I think both Moody and Modi, both are not able to gauge the mood of the nation. Situation at the ground level is completely different from what these international agencies are suggesting.
First, a 30-place jump in World Bank's ranking for ease of doing business. And now a top rating agency upgrading India. A huge endorsement for Modinomics. Bureau Report, Times Now.
And joining me this evening, live and exclusive, is Finance Minister Arun Jaitley. Mr. Jaitley, good evening and welcome to the News Hour tonight. Mr. Jaitley, how do you respond 13 years after it happened in 2004 during the Atal Bihari Vajpayee era? Moody's Investor Service has upgraded India yet again, but the opposition can only look at this as a fixed match. They say this is a Modi-Modi fixed match. And of course, Rahul Gandhi says it's a Gabbar Singh tax impact, which the foreigners don't understand, only Indians understand.
You see, when the World Bank rankings pushed India up by 30 positions in 1 year, which is some sort of a record, there was a similar reaction. Let us not forget that 3.5 years ago, in May 2014, when the UPA and the Congress was in power, India was being labeled as an economy which was suffering from policy paralysis. So all the pontificators and the column writers and the commentators on the Indian economy today were those who were presiding over a policy paralysis. India had witnessed one of the most corrupt governments in history. India had gone off the radar as far as global investors was concerned. You had international commentators saying that in the BRICS, there was a legitimate case for I to be dropped out of the BRICS. Now, that is where we started in May 2014 from. And since 2014, we have consistently re-established the credibility of Indian economy. We have run a government which is completely an honest government, a transparent government. We have brought about economic reforms which are directional in nature and which have the impact of giving strength to the Indian economy in the medium and the long term. We have shied away from populism and gone in for stability. The kind of fiscal prudence that we have practiced has hardly ever been seen as far as the Indian economy is concerned. Consistently, we have been, for the last 3 years, the fastest growing economy amongst the major economies in the world. In 3 years, we've moved up 42 positions as far as the World Bank rankings in the ease of business is concerned. And therefore, a culmination of a large number of structural reforms, particularly demonetization, leading towards a whole lot of direction where Indian economy moved towards digitization, the GST, which is a landmark tax reform, which is smoothing itself out by almost every day with the rationalization of the tax taking place, landmark measures like the insolvency and the bankruptcy code, the Aadhaar legislation by which dissipation of social benefits can now be specifically targeted. These are all which have been conceptually and theoretically spoken about for years. We have actually implemented them. Now, the Congress, of course, has been relying on the fact that in the short term, when transformations take place, people take time to adjust to those transformational changes. But I think that's the difference between small-time petty politics and a long-term nation building. We are involved in the later exercise, and I think those who have been making outlandish statements about the state of the Indian economy must now seriously get on and introspect whether there was a serious position or otherwise.
But Mr. Jaitley, let's be realistic. The domestic investment outlook does not keep pace, does not keep step with what the international agencies are saying. There is an atmosphere of doom and gloom. Private investment is not taking off. Obviously, opposition parties, especially Rahul Gandhi, is emboldened to take these digs because the private investment atmosphere, the job scenario in India, is not what Moody's is telling us today.
Well, I think as far as the domestic investment cycle is concerned, it's certainly improving. We can see in a number of sectors, domestic companies now making investment. Take telecom, for example. Take the highway sector, for example. But then the domestic sector had a legacy problem left behind by the Congress. It is during the post-boom period that the banks under the UPA government had indiscriminately lent. Companies had expanded their capacities, particularly when the global demand was falling, and that resulted in a twin balance sheet problem where the company's balance sheets were scarred and those in turn scarred the balance sheets of the banks. Now, we are in the position with the recapitalization and the IBC of rectifying the economic sins committed by the Congress. These were legacy problems which we inherited in 2014. So the Congress can hardly say, oh, this is a problem. Well, this is a problem which you left behind, and we are trying to resolve that particular problem. That's a reality as far as the Indian economy is concerned.
But sir, the World Bank last year, you questioned the World Bank's methodology when it was critical of your performance. You questioned last year the Moody's entire methodology when they questioned your debt ratios, your debt performance, your debt indicators. You questioned Moody's. Today, just because they are appreciative and they are giving you a leg up, you're suddenly extremely jubilant about the kind of credit ratings that are coming in, the kind of reports they are putting in, both the World Bank and the Moody's?
No, let's be very clear. No, last year, when the World Bank rankings pushed us only by one position, we felt that a lot of reforms had taken place in India, which merited a movement upwards. The World Bank's position was that our cutoff date is the 1st of June, and we don't see the measure being announced by the government, but we see the actual implementation on the ground. Well, so be it. If that's the World Bank standard, we lived with that reality. And after 1 year, people saw the implementation on the ground. Similarly, as far as Moody's is concerned, I certainly believe that the recognition of India's economy and its strength, as also the Indian reform process, is already belated. It could have happened last year, but nonetheless, I am quite delighted that it's happened this year.
But Mr. Jaitley, let me tell you, and that's a reality of life, that elections are not going to be won through Moody's or through the World Bank reports or through the Pew popularity ratings. They are going to be fought and won on ground zero in India. So in India, the doom and gloom scenario is a reality, Mr. Jaitley. And in the run-up to 2019, many are saying the sheen that was there in 2014 on Mr. Narendra Modi, the Prime Minister, is now no longer there. Are you going to be able to reinvent yourself over the next 18 months before 2019 if you want to make a bid for power in 2019?
Well, I'm quite certain the government even today retains its popularity. I am yet to come across a single opinion poll which shows that either Mr. Modi or the government's popularity is down. I am still to see a single poll which shows that we are not doing well either in Himachal Pradesh or in Gujarat, where the elections are now being held. And therefore, merely because somebody carries on a propaganda and then buys his own propaganda doesn't mean that there is some kind of a tide which is turning. These kind of loud and outlandish statements never change the course of political history in a country.
Mr. Jaitley, are you sincerely being misled by the Pew's ratings? Because the criticism is it's a very small sample size, 2,500 people. That's really not an indicator of what 125 crore people in India are feeling.
Well, that's all right. People will question. People will question every survey. People will question every legitimate move which takes place in India. But at the same time, those questions must have a legitimate basis to it. After all, these are respectable international agencies which have stood the test of time. If somebody doesn't want to believe them, so be it. You can't compel them to believe them.
All right. On a day, the Moody's has given you a thumbs up, Mr. Jaitley. Nobody can take it away from you that at least it's three thumbs up in a row that you've got. Where does that leave Mr. Rahul Gandhi? That's the question to ask. Thank you, Mr. Jaitley, for joining us on the News Hour here.
You're watching the News Hour at 9. Debate number 1 on Times Now. Super Prime Time.
Opening up the debate on on Modi's back. Modi, that's the debate that's being opened up. Dr. Sambit Patra, national spokesperson of the BJP, M.R. Venkatesh, political analyst, Dr. Ajay Alok, spokesperson of the JDU, Dr. Dinesh Vashne, leader of the CPI, Ghanshyam Tiwari, national spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party, Alimuddin Khan, political analyst, joining me live from Guwahati. He leans towards the Congress party. And Mr. Alimuddin Khan, may I ask you, in 2013, these words were said by the Congress party. They said, realistic effort to correct India's macroeconomic imbalances. This plan of modest fiscal consolidation is credit positive for sovereign because against a backdrop of subdued GDP growth and upcoming elections, it's a realistic effort to correct India's macroeconomic imbalances. This is what Modi said about the UPA government, P. Chidambaram's budget in 2013, and it was an ecstatic Congress party that lauded the Moody's report. What's happened to you today? You're calling it a fixed match between Modi and Moody? Bad losers?
Navika ji, this Moody was fined by the Federal Court of USA in year 2008. For $864 million by the Federal Court of the USA for giving wrong reports. So this report itself is in question, number one. The Moody's itself in question, number one. Number two, they have surveyed 3,360 people in this country of 120 crores. So how these 3,600 people in this country can decide the economy of this country and they calculate? GDP during Congress, when Modi ji took over, it was 7.5. Now they are talking that if they continue with their plan, the GDP will reach to 6.5 in year 2018, not now. Year 2000, March 2018, while GDP present, GDP is to 3.7. So how this government is coming, what this government is doing exactly is that they are sowing dreams, they are selling dreams to the country, fake surveys, fake economic surveys, fake political surveys, everything is fake. And that's why people are calling fake. So what do you say about it? Everything is fake. At least come real, please. Okay. Tell the nation reality. What is the economic situation of the country after GST and demonetization? Tell truth to the
Dr.
nation.
Sambit Patra, the truth, Dr. Sambit Patra, that's
fake survey.
That's a valid question. People have questioned the fact that Moody's has been fined in the past. How do you now suddenly begin to laud the Moody's report when there have been questions raised about Moody's in the past?
See, Navika, it's an irony today. Today, in fact, rather than fighting, we should be congratulating each other because at the end of the day, a credible organization of the world, which in fact is a rating agency, which every country in the world follows,
oh, Baba, has upgraded India as far as by the Federal Court of the USA.
So today, please, sir, I was not...
I
was not shouting, sir. I don't want to shout, sir. I don't want to shout. Can I... Navika, I don't want to
Dr.
shout.
Patra, you can
so let him speak and thereafter I will speak. Let him please continue.
Will be not done by you here on television, sir. Please accept the truth that you are sowing the fake survey
okay,
to the nation.
Mr. Alimuddin Khan.
Let this Nobel laureate of economy speak first and then I would speak. Navika, let me tell you one thing. This is the only country, and I'm shamed today, that here... I'm shamed today, Navika, and people outside of this country would be laughing that this is the only country where the country receives a congratulatory message and here we fight amongst ourselves that why should we have this kind of rating upgradation? The Congress party and our opponents in this rhetoric of politics would be very happy if there would have been a downgradation. That is the nature of politics today. Secondly, and most importantly, leave aside Moody. What did, in fact, the World Economic Forum say only a few days ago? What did the International Monetary Fund chairperson say only a few days ago? When Christine said only a few days ago that India was a bright spot in the world economy, they did not believe her. When the World Economic Forum came up with the ease of doing business and they said that India has jumped up consistently and has created a world record of sorts as far as ease of doing business is concerned, Abhishek Manu Singhvi and Rahul Gandhi said that the World Economic Forum was fixed. So for them, the United Nations is nothing. For them, the World Bank is nothing. For them, the Moody's is nothing.
World
Only
Bank,
thing
sir.
That matters to them is
World
Pretty.
Bank, sir.
Let them, as
at
it may
least,
be, let them enjoy
get your
Pretty
reports right.
Let the World Bank be denounced by them. Let the UN be denounced by them. Let the Economic Forum be denounced by them. Let the IMF be denounced by them. But we have to move this way. But secondly, can I please make these points? Please, please, sir. Alimuddin ji, can I ask the Nobel laureate in economy to allow this poor chap some time? Please allow a poor Sambit Patra to speak, sir. I know you are a Nobel laureate in economy, but please allow me to speak. Take it. Now let me come to the Navika, there is a point when people say, why do we have to borrow from Moody's? See, leave aside Moody, that's why I said, leave aside Moody and come to the mood of the nation on the ground. Consistently from 2014, I firmly believe that People of India is the highest rating agency. Consistently after 2014, almost every election has been won by Bharatiya Janata Party and every election has been horribly lost by our opponents, including the recent Gujarat elections. I mean, including the recent Uttar Pradesh elections, where Bharatiya Janata Party
Gujarat
got 325
election
seats
are yet to
and the
happen,
opponents
sir, you
were saying
are going to
that
Gujarat,
because of demonetization
worry.
Doom, Bharatiya... Please don't shout, sir. So 325 seats and the Congress got only 6 seats. So naturally, we can see the rhetorics of politics, of failing politics and unemployed politics of Congress
sir,
party today.
Sir,
so I firmly believe this is the moment of congratulation, the biggest word which
you
I would like to borrow. Sir, please don't shout.
Don't sing
sir,
the
please,
song
please
of the 2014.
Alimuddin ji, please let's have
come to 2017.
Alimuddin ji, please don't have... Alimuddin ji, logon ko ye pasand nahi hai, itna mat chilaiye.
You are going to lose everything.
We have, yes, we have lost.
Don't
we have lost the whole of India. We lost
election.
The 2014 elections, and Rahul Gandhi is the Prime Minister of the country
sir,
today.
Yeah,
you are right. Rahul Gandhi is the Prime Minister
sir,
of the country.
Doctor,
today.
You are
all
well,
lost
sir.
Everything. Please don't shout, sir. Please, let's have a sane debate. This is economic debates. Let's not behave like street thugs and shout over
but
each
let
other.
Let me get in
Thank
the others.
So much,
let me get in Mr. Ghanshyam Tiwari.
Mr.
Ghanshyam Tiwari.
Navika, just 10 seconds. I request you, and then my friend Ghanshyam can come in. Just 10 seconds, because
okay.
I heard Mr. Arun Jaitley ji, and the word which I would like to throw for the debate over here is direction. Direction, in fact, Mr. Jaitley in the morning press conference also said that the most important import from this whole Moody's rating was directional. That India is in the right direction because of both economic reforms as well as institutional reforms. Don't you think we should be rejoiced by this? And why are we fighting? I don't understand.
That's the point. Ghanshyam Tiwari, let's be clear. You know, when World Bank, when the Moody's rating agencies, when they upgrade India, it's a matter of pride for the entire country. Why are we looking at this partisan way? Look at the kind of comments we've seen from the opposition parties. Rahul has called GST Gabbar Singh tax. Rahul has called demonetization Modi made disaster. Manmohan Singh has called demonetization a monumental failure. Akhilesh Yadav has called demonetization a midnight curse. Sitaram Yechuri has called demonetization a successful money laundering scheme. Have all of these people who criticize both demonetization and GST today been silenced with Moody's actually appreciating both these moves? Saying that digitization of the economy as well as GST, the huge reform, is actually setting up this country for a huge growth in GDP, in investment in the coming years.
Well, it is the Moody report is a denial of the current state of Indian economy. Moody's aside, everyone else seems skeptical. This is not me who's saying. This is the Wall Street Journal today morning reported this to the world. So on one end is Moody, whose track record is questionable. Just this year, the European Union has fined Moody for €1.4 million. But coming to the substantial point, that if India gets a report like Moody's report, an upgrade, it is a welcome report. It sends a signal to the world that India is a country where you can come and invest. But when you look at the country from inside, as a political voice, we look at the country from the inside. The quick question is that, are jobs getting created? Is your informal sector flourishing? The Moody's report or Ease of Doing Business report says that informal sector in this country is getting curtailed. It is not getting curtailed. It is getting killed by policies like demonetization and GST, and informal sector is the one that gives jobs to the millions of untrained and poorly educated youth across the country in the rural belt, because they don't need a huge setup cost. My final point is, if you look at the Wall Street Journal article today, and I invite you to present it to people, it says that India's GDP, debt to GDP ratio is 68%, which is much higher than the peers. It also says that there are no signals that allow Modi to quote any reform. The only point where all these people agree is demonetization was good for the country, because it allows foreign money to enter where our average rural entrepreneurs were flourishing. Demonetization has single-handedly killed the informal sector, killed the poorest of the poor, the farmers, the nano micro enterprises, and Prime Minister Modi has to take the blame. They did not demand Achhe Din, did not promise Achhe Din to Moody's, World Bank and IMF. They promised Achhe Din to the poorest of the poor. They gave them the vote. If India is becoming so rich, as Samit Patra wants the nation to believe, why can't they give minimum support price to the farmers? Why can't they
create jobs? Dr. Ajay Alok, I mean, how can the same thing be read completely differently by different people? When I read the Moody's report, it says to me, GST promotes productivity by removing barriers, improves the monetary policy framework, widens government's tax base, will help addressing the overhang of non-performing loans, demonetization reduces corruption, helps formalization of the economy, Aadhaar system of biometric accounts actually improves the direct benefit transfer, which reduces corruption, which promotes expenditure efficiency, formalization of the economy, and it says that the forecast of growth will be 6.7% this year, going on to 7.5% next year, and further growth in the years after. How can all of this positivity be read completely negatively by the opposition, Dr. Ajay Alok? Is there something wrong in the way we are reading things and the Moody's is saying things? Or is there something wrong in the way the opposition is looking at things?
Navika, I said this many times on your channel, that opposition always stands to react. They don't set their own agenda. And now I'm phrasing this, that opposition right now suffering from ostrich syndrome. They don't want to see what is happening good for the country, even something happening good for the country. They just want to avoid it and ignore it, rather than ostrich dipping at their head in the sand that, no, we cannot see anything. I mean, Moody, if it's improving India's rating, India's global position is improving, that is a good sign for the country, number one. Number two, you may be having your point of disagreement over the various things, but it is not for the first time. Like the Prime Minister Modi has done something immediately, and Moody has reflected the rating. For the last 13 years, Moody has never done the same. Now, if you see if you line the measures he has taken after becoming the Prime Minister, you will see that this was a very much calculated move. Right since inception in 2014. I mean, the first thing he started, Make in India. What was to boost the manufacturing and improve the labor laws. Fine, you say you can have 100 problems in Make in India, but at least it was started. Now, January 2015 comes Jan Dhan Yojana. More than 30 crores account till now has been opened. This is a fact, you cannot deny it. And lots of money have been deposited. Don't you believe that this is a sign of digital India? Now, next come demonetization. What happens with demonetization? Most of the black money which was there goes into these accounts. Now then comes the game changer, GST. Then after the GST, now it is a mandatory linking of Aadhaar card with your bank account, so that all the black money which was deposited during demonetization into bank account will be taken care of in next 6 months by the income tax authorities. Now see, these are all well-planned measures, one after the another, which has resulted which has resulted in getting this kind of ratings even from World Bank or from Moody or from any XYZ agencies. Now, if you see the various reforms, like increase in FDI, in railways, in insurance, in defense, all this has led to belief in the international community that yes, now there is a strong leadership which can take a political decision, and the windows of opportunity are there in India, and we are not going to suffer anything because of a political misgivings which were happening. The policy paralysis is not there. Now, see, creation of Niti Aayog is one another classical example where
a quick rebuttal, whether
it is Moody or the report from the State Bank of India, you take any report. Every report is saying that today India has more credit available than the industry's ability to take it up to expand their business, to create jobs. When Ajay Alok supports demonetization, I fear for people of Bihar, because it is these people who lost their jobs, were shunned from Mumbai and other places, and had to return home. And when you look at the chart of Prime Minister
None
Modi
of the people lost their jobs in Bihar. Now let me report to you, Mr. Ghanshyam.
There is corruption index, we are highest as per transparency.
Can I reply to you?
In Asia, there's freedom of press index.
Can I reply to you as far as jobs are concerned?
Every major industry.
Mr. Ghanshyam Tiwari, please have the patience to listen to my reply, please.
Do not count on just one report and hail it as the Prime Minister Modi.
I've listened to your question, man. Let me reply at least. This is ostrich syndrome again. Listen to my reply. Where you are getting all these data of jobs from? Where do you get these data of jobs? That how many jobs were created in 1 year? Where do you get these data? Either from the employment exchange of all the state and the central government concerned, or from the websites of the websites on the major PSU concerned. As far as government jobs are concerned, you will get the data from only these agencies. Now, according to that, you rate, and from the major private investment sector, you can get the data on their website also, that how many jobs were created. Based on that, you give your job prediction that only this much job were created. Now, is this a fact? Now, what about those data? Like, 3.5 crores people got loan under Mudra Yojana. Government has distributed more than around, I guess, 10,000 crores in loans, which have created a small-scale enterprises, which are giving jobs to others. What about those jobs? Have you taken that account? Do you have that data with you?
Please, you can come and see how much loans people have taken and they have gone into small-scale industries. Mr. Dinesh Vashne, India's rating upgrade comes just months after Moody downgraded China in May, followed by Standard & Poor's, which also downgraded China. So are you going to lament China's downgrade, or are you going to celebrate India's upgrade?
I am not going to lament anybody, and nor do I am going to support the upgrade. I tell you how. All these rating agencies, there are three major economic depression has come in the world. One in 1929, another in 2006, another third one is in India, that is after demonetization. Tell me any downgrading of the economy in the second economic depression of the world, that is 2006 to 2012, of any European nation or America or Australia or Canada or England, where 10,000 banks failed. 10,000 banks failed. Not a single downgrading of their economy rating. Number two, these rating agencies are the tools of the IMF and World Bank for the benefit of the finance capital. I tell you how. When America's subprime rating, higher rating was done by the Moody, the America lost huge amount of money in that. People of America suffered. That is why the American Federal Court penalized this Moody agency, which Alimuddin Khan was referring, which is correct. They may deny this fact, but this is a fact. Read it in .writers.com. It is mentioned there. Number three, all those governments in the developing world, when their political leadership fail in their policy matters, try to lobby with these tools. Read the finance ministry letters. How many letters they have written to Moody to upgrade the lobbying? Upgrade the rating.
M.R. Venkatesh, when you
hear these opposition leaders,
I get a feeling it's doom, gloom, and Moody's has not upgraded us. World Bank has not upgraded us. Pius has not come out with any
All these are imperialist Prime Minister Modi.
Actually, we should all sit with our head in our hands and actually cry because India is coming to an end.
Navika,
is
you
that
tell
the
me,
situation, MR
Indian people,
because,
Indian people
because
income
my
has declined 40%.
My viewers,
monopoly
tonight,
income has increased 76%.
Max Roop, if our economy is that much good,
let Dr. Sambit Patra promise to the Times of India, Times Now TV today, to the people of India, that the petrol diesel prices will come by half as our neighboring countries are selling.
Look at our economy, let all be given PDS,
let all education be government education, why privatization of education, let all be given the informal sector job.
Can I come in? Go to Palwal, go to Sonipat, go to Manesar, go to Bulandshahr, go to Amar Venkatesh. Viewers are saying the Congress personal wealth of their leaders from corruption and scams is a sign of development and sound GDP growth. That's SRK who says that.
Another viewer says,
people of India today are aspirational and every party has to realize that. Simply criticizing the government doesn't really work. Max Roop says that. And Alimuddin Khan never supports the Prime Minister because he cannot understand economics. That is stated by Mr. Shantarama Murthy from Bengaluru. These are comments coming from our viewers, MR Venkatesh. Do you feel the world is coming to an end, or at least India is coming to a standstill after hearing these opposition leaders? I'm feeling very depressed tonight after hearing them.
Okay. Anybody who talks of the welfare economy, don't listen to this opposition leaders, and that is the best medicine I can suggest to you. Now, as far as Navika, can I have an uninterrupted time, Navika? If this gentleman is going to speak, I cannot be talking.
Beg your pardon for that. Yes, make your point, MR Venkatesh.
Please allow me to speak. It's around 9:40. I didn't interrupt anybody. Now listen, as far as ratings are concerned, they take a host of different parameters. And the best parameter or the most important crucial parameter that must have gone into any rating agency was that the previous UPA government was a loot and scoot government. It was Alibaba with 40 thieves. Here the Alibaba himself was not of a reputable character and he himself was party to the loot. Now the whole thing changes from May 2014. You have a new dispensation. They allowed 3 years of running of this new dispensation. And they come to a conclusion that corruption has come down in this country and the growth that was there in the 2004 to 2014 period was that of steroids, out of corruption, out of manipulation, of crony capitalism, of loot and scoot Sarkar. Now all those things have come down and what you have a transparent, you have a better, and I'm not saying milk and honey is flowing in the streets of Delhi. Please understand, there is a perceptible change in the perception. That is the most important thing that investors look. Investors look at, not into much of these details, investors look at how does the Prime Minister of this country behave, whether he is one who is sits with a set of people who are like A Rajas and the others who are known for their loot and scoot economics, or are they somebody who are of some repute? Now today the NDA government has cabinet ministers who deliver, a prime minister who knows what he is doing. That brings out enormous confidence on the people. That brings down investment, global investment, and this is borne out by the fact that the highest GDP, highest foreign direct investment is flowing into this country at a all-time high, historical high. Yes, there are a lot of areas on which reforms have to happen, on which government has to concentrate. If the opposition of the day were to pinpoint it with actual prescriptions of how the government should go about reforming these areas, then the opposition will do themselves a great favor. If they are going to be on a Rudali mode, the country is going to condemn them to where they belong, and they belong to the dustbin of history. Let us remember this. The nation is not ready to No, please understand. Let me complete. You people are in a Rudali mode because you don't have an opposition opposition leader.
You
don't have a
policy.
60 years you have drained my blood. 60 years you have drained my blood. And people have put you into where you belong to, the dustbin of history. Now you better be in the dustbin of history and allow Mr. Narendra Modi to perform.
Reported that investment in this country has fallen year over year compared to last year.
Well,
so that's
well,
one.
Ali Mudin Khan, let me get it.
That is domestic investment. Foreign direct investment has increased. $62 billion.
Yes, I will give you all the numbers.
Please understand that.
MR Venkatesh, you are fooling the people of this country by stating these things. Will you please come to these three parameters?
Okay, the comment coming from you, Mr. Dinesh Vasney. You are saying MR Venkatesh is fooling the country. Ravindra Hegde is saying commies are poor. Commies are poor economists. Dinesh Vasney is the last of the commies whose wants are surviving on borrowed oxygen.
Just on a lighter note,
let me tell you, this is one of the reports that has not been fined. That Moody said in 2012, and Mr. Ali Mudin Khan, listen to this. Moody said in 2012 that the Gandhi family has not done anything. The real power behind the government, the Gandhi family, blew their chance to restart the legislative process at the recent state elections, in which the family scion Rahul Gandhi invested countless hours and money touring the rural backwaters of Uttar Pradesh, but did nothing for reforms and progress in the country. That's Moody's, and this report has not been fined, sir. This is a report of 2012. And let me tell you the FDI details. FDI details, the UPA government in the last 3 years, I'm taking 3 years because I've got 3 years data of the Modi government. 3 years, UPA government had $116 billion FDI. The Narendra Modi government has $170 billion government. Now, Manmohan Singh was an economist, and P. Chidambaram, in his own words, has said that the economics that Mr. Narendra Modi knows can be written on the back of a postage stamp. Then why did Mr. P. Chidambaram, finance minister, Dr. Manmohan Singh, economist, prime minister, garner only $116 billion as FDI? Why is $170 billion coming in the Narendra Modi regime? You can still not see anything positive, Mr. Ali Mudin Khan?
Navika ji,
ostrich
you
syndrome.
See, we are
see
just trying
positive.
To show the show mirror ostrich. To this Modi regime. They should, BJP regime, but they don't want to see the mirror. Before they look at it, they break it. That is the problem. Be it unemployment, be it GST, be it effect of the demonetization, or any trouble on the border, or
you take your head out of the stand, then only you can show the mirror.
Ajay Alok ji,
you guys are behaving like with an ostrich syndrome.
BJP, he was talking in a different tune. Today, Ajay Alok ji talking in a different tune.
Now, where's the question of alliance comes here? I am showing. Even while we were with you, we supported government. We supported government on GST demonetization. And every good thing they have done.
Wake up, that's
the difference between you and me. Even when we were in alliance, we supported this government on demonetization, surgical strike, GST.
No, you
for,
never,
for which
you,
Mr. Rahul Gandhi was
you,
not
you
happy. But we were not.
No,
we never lived in ostrich syndrome. You guys are only reactionary. You don't have any agenda.
You
only react to Prime Minister Modi. You just don't have any agenda.
Dr. Sambit Patra wants to come in.
Problem.
Okay, gentlemen. Okay, gentlemen. Dr. Sambit Patra wants to come in. Dr. Sambit Patra. Ali Mudin Khan sahab, bolne dijiye. Dr. Sambit Patra. Yes, Dr. Sambit Patra. I'll have to lower your fader, Dr. I'm short of time, Alimuddin Khan Saab. Allow Dr. Sambit Patra to rebut.
See, first and foremost, rather than have shouting match over here in the debate, this is a very serious issue. The country has been upgraded. Let us go to the fine prints of what the Moody's rating agency have said. I mean, the second important word after directional change, I think, is the formalization of Indian economy. It talks about demonetization, GST, it talks about Aadhaar, it talks about direct benefit transfer as to how every year, because of DBT, Indian government is saving 60,000 crore rupees. It talks about insolvency code, it talks about bankruptcy code, and rightly pointed out by Mr. Arun Jaitley that in the yesteryears these were only proposed ideas, the ideas which were thought at the back of the mind but which were never finding its way into the table. Today, finally, Mr. Alimuddin, please don't shout like this. I request you. Please behave, Mr. Alimuddin. Alimuddin ji, maine aapke beech mein nahi bola. Please behave, sir. You are a grown-up person, sir. Let's not shout. You are a grown-up person, sir. Let's not behave like this.
India for bullet train.
Bet ye, sir. Navika, I don't want to have a shouting match like this. I don't want to shout like this. This is a very serious debate. So now, please, Mr. Alimuddin, will you keep quiet and behave?
Alimuddin Khan Saab, I'll have to lower your fader down. I'm warning you. I will lower your fader. Yes, Dr. Patra.
Thank you, Navika. Navika, the formalization of Indian economy. Look at the irony. All these years we were talking about how to tackle with black money and how to formalize the Indian economy. It's astonishing fact that despite 70 years of our independence, 40% of India's population was outside of the formal banking system. And this contributes significantly to this Moody's rating, to the World Bank rating, etc., etc., that today, because of Jan Dhan Yojana, we have seen that every person today has a account in the bank. And secondly, what Mr. Jaitley was rightly pointing towards was the twin balance sheet problem. In the yesteryears, because of the companies which had a SCARD account, and these companies in return gave us carrying to the bank accounts. Today, because of recapitalization of the bank, we see a future of investment in this country. And is it not true? Because of these measures in this last 3 years, India's forex reserve today stands in a world record high. We are $4 billion, which are present as Indian forex
world record high.
Secondly, the Moody's ratings talks about the fiscal prudence.
Sambit, there is a three-letter word called JOB, jobs.
Previously, India never had this forex reserve.
Can you tell the country how many jobs were created?
There are a few letter words called please keep quiet. Please keep quiet. Cycle puncture ho gayi hai. Aap cycle mein puncture lagaiye. Itna mat chillaiye sir. Modi baad mein padhiyega jaake cycle mein puncture. Are pehle cycle mein puncture lagaiye bhaiya. Modi padhne chale hain. Jaake dono bhai aap aur Rahul Gandhi cycle mein puncture lagaiye pehle. Dono cycle mein baith ke puncture hua pada hai yahan ke Modi padhne chale hain.
We don't need to answer you.
Navika, Navika,
tell the big money that yes,
ये दोनों कितने परेशान हैं भैया? ये कितने परेशान हैं?
Small time entrepreneur on the ground. You cannot tell
कुछ कुछ नहीं हो सकता इनका कुछ नहीं हो सकता है ये कुछ पूरा साइकिल छिन जाएगा जैसे हाथी चली गई है तब जाके ये सुधरेंगे बैठिए ये ऐसे ऐसे करने से कुछ नहीं होगा ये ऐसे ऐसे करने से कुछ नहीं होगा सुनिए मेरी बात नाविका इट इज नॉट जस्ट द मूडी यस्टरडे द प्यू सर्वे आल्सो टॉक्स अबाउट द प्यू सर्वे आल्सो टॉक्स अबाउट द
पार्लियामेंट जनता ऐसे ऐसे करेगी और आपको धक्के मार के निकाल देगी अलाउ द पार्लियामेंट टू फंक्शन टेल व्हेन द विंटर सेशन विल हैपन एंड लास्ट मिनट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस
घनश्याम तिवारी दैट यू नो एंटायर आर्गुमेंट अबाउट द पार्लियामेंट सेशन इज द ओनली आर्गुमेंट यू हैव बीन ब्रिंगिंग टू द टेबल फॉर द लास्ट वन वीक थिंक ऑफ अ न्यू आर्गुमेंट थिंक ऑफ a new argument you are sounding like a stuck record may I just tell you in the opposition parties and you were supporting the UPA government Ghanshyam Tiwari so this goes out to you when the UPA came into power, and you were also supporting the UPA at that time, the left party.
Number
in 2003-2004, UPA came to power, the growth rate, the GDP growth rate was 8.1. When they left power in 2014, it was 4.7. Is the pot calling the kettle black? That's the question we want to ask Rahul Gandhi tonight. That's the question, viewers. We leave for you to ask the opposition parties, because should we be celebrating the three reports, the Moody's, the World Bank report and the Pew popularity ratings, or should we be actually celebrating the doom and gloom that's being painted by the opposition? The choice is yours. Thank you very much for joining me on Moody Backs Modi on the News Hour tonight. Taking a short break, the News Hour at 10, coming up next with Anand Narasimhan. Stay tuned, don't go away.